Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, uhibbuka ya Rasulullah. Amazing flag, amazing shi'ar to call that, oh Prophet of Allah, I do love you so much, so that I revive your story, I revive your sunnah, I would like to know more about your life. Every time I read one of the story, even if I hear it long time ago, 20 years ago, and every day I hear it, every day I feel it deeper and deeper and deeper, and try to abstract moral lesson to my life, because I can find solution in my life when I analyze the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he deal with all situation. As we are up to those huge, massive, strong wave of evil from the head of the kuffar and the pharaoh of the kuffar, Abu Jahl and Umayyah and all those sanadidul kuffar, the top of the devils among of the human being, they came with full of hatred to stop the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to stop the truth, to stop the people believing in Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow the light and follow the way of Jannah. They done all possible way, and we mention some of their names. They went to the rubbish of the history of mankind, such as Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab wa Umayyah bin Khalaf and all those top of evil, wa Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayt wa Al-As bin Wa'il. Those people, they get together to do all possible evil. They kill some of the Sahaba, they tortured them again and again, and they use all the intellectual and fast and smart ideas to stop the Islam and destroy the Islam, and they fail with all possible way. And we are up to the first hijrah, the first migration of Islam. Let's find out who did this hijrah and what happened, and who they were, who they are, and what their stories. After Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he announced the da'wah. 3 years was the da'wah, secretly, privately, in the house of Dar Bani al-Arqam, Ibn Abi al-Arqam. 3 years. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he announced the da'wah, and as you know, the kuffar, they did all possible way to stop Islam and destroyed and tortured who believe and say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Then first year passed by with very critical situation. Then they moved to the following year. So how many years now? 3 years privately. The first, number 4, and then number 5. In the year of 5th, some of the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, they could not handle the situation, and they come up with the idea to migrate to Al-Habasha, which is in Africa and in Abyssinia. So African people, among of them, they used to have a leader, his name Al-Najashi, and that Al-Najashi, he was a justice ruler. MashaAllah, beautiful, amazing community from Africa. They support Islam. They have a leader. He was a Christian, but he was a justice. And he loved Islam, and he became Muslim privately. And the only person that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he done Salatul Janaza in the absent. The only one, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he did Salatul Janaza in his absent, was the Najashi, and Najashi was in Africa, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam was in Medina, and Nabi sallallahu prayed Salatul Janaza for al Najashi, because he believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he became Muslim, and he remained silent because he knew if he announced Islam, they will destroy him and kill him and eliminate him from power, and he would like to protect the Muslims who they are in Africa. So wisdom is very important. Sometimes people, they do things without thinking. Look at the Najashi, he was smart. Better for Islam, I keep myself silent. for this kind of situation. Of course, every situation, there is a solution. Different situation, different solutions. But other Sahaba, Umar al-Khattab, did he keep silent? No, he announced that I am a Muslim, and he announced that in front of the kuffar, and he migrate openly. So his situation different than Najashi. So every single believer has a different situation, and he understand what the sequence will going to be happen. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fidahu abi wa ummi, he is more beloved to my heart than my father and mother sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, لو خرجتم إلى أرض الحبشة to Abyssinia, فَإِنَّ فِيهَا مَلِكًا, it has a king, لَا يُظْلَمُ أَحَدٌ عِنْدَ, no one get harmed with that king, حَتَّى يَجْعَلُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ فَرَجًا وَمَخْرَجًا بِمَا أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ فِيهِ, until you find a safer, and you find a rescue, and you find a better place, until you get the peace, then you can come and migrate back to Mecca. So they went to Abyssinia. Who went with them? They were around 10 persons. Among of them, Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anh, the third Khalifa, and his wife. Who is his wife? Ruqayya. Who is Ruqayya? The daughter of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And among of them, Abu Hudhayfa bin Anbasa bin Rabi'a, and he has his wife Sahla bint Suhail, and Zubayr bin Awam, he's the uncle of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they went, they are a small number, 10 people. They went to Abyssinia, and they remain Shahr Sha'ban, the month of Sha'ban, and the month of Ramadan, in the fifth year. So they went only 2 months. Then they returned back to Mecca in the month of Shawwal, after Ramadan. So what happened? Why they returned back? Because they heard a news that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the kuffar, they create like a terms and agreement of peace, so there is no any problem, and this is a lie. Why it's been spread around? It has a story. One time Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, feel the beauty that you are talking and you hear the name of the Prophet of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, say sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One time he was in Mecca, in Kaaba, next to Kaaba, and he recited over the kuffar from Surah Al-Najm. And he recited the verse, أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ اللَّاتَ وَالْعُزَّى وَمَنَاتَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى. أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ, did you see, did you see what? اللَّاتَ وَالْعُزَّى. اللَّات is one of the idols the kuffar, they used to worship him. Wal Uzza, also another idol, the kuffar used to worship him. Wa Mana, also it's idols, and the kuffar used to worship him. Wa Manat al-Thalithat al-Ukhra. So Allah mentioned 3 names of idols. Alqa al-Shaytanu fi masami' al-Mushrikeen qawlihi tilka al-Gharaniq al-Ula. A'udhu billah, ya Allah. Like when I read this story, my brain blew up. Shaitan, he was able to deceive the kuffar. When Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam recite this verse, he make a sound to add after this verse, and he announced to the kuffar, تلك الغرانيق العلا وإن شفاعتهم لترجى. Those, they are the big idols, and to seek the intercession shafa'ah, you should seek it. Then the kuffar hear that sound. So what comes to their mind? That Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he is the one recite this 2 ayat. Two fabrication statement. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam carry on reciting Surah Al-Najm until the end of the surah. Huh? What is the end of the surah? أَزِفَةِ الْآزِفَةِ لَيْسَ لَهَا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ كَاشِفَةً أَفَمِنْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ تَعْجَبُونَ وَتَضْحَكُونَ وَلَا تَبْكُونَ وَأَنْتُمْ سَامِدُونَ فَاسْجُدُوا لِلَّهِ وَاعْبُدُوا. Subhanallah. From this saying, you making laugh and you don't cry, as if at the day of judgment is so close, And in the end, fasjudu, make sujood and worship Allah. So the kuffar, when Nabi Sallam went for sujood, they followed Nabi Sallam and they did sujood. But why the kuffar make sujood? They thought that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had with Allah their gods, so we can do the sujood to Allah plus together to the idols. So mix, mixed rice. Meat and chicken and beef. So we believe in Allah, no problem. We believe in Islam, no problem. But also, we want to believe in our idols. Like nowadays, a lot of ideas, they want to put the Islam and Christianity and Judaism together as a one religion. They call Abrahamic. So how come people believe God is a three and we believe God is one? We're going to combine in the same aqidah. Cannot be. Yani, subhanAllah, they just try to put some spicy, looks like beautiful. We can have a peace together, but lakum dinukum waliya din. We don't fight, we don't hate each other, but my aqidah, my faith, tell me something different than your faith. And you have your own faith. So this is really important. So the news propaganda received to those people who migrate to Abyssinia, so they thought there is a peace. But in the fact, wal-iyadhu billah, after that, when they arrive to Mecca, they found the kuffar become extremely hatred, and they become double torturing and double doing more evil way towards the believers, and all it was fabrication from shaitan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed ayah in surah, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ وَلَا نَبِيٍ إِلَّا إِذَا تَمَنَّى أَلْقَى الشَّيْطَانُ فِي أُمْنِيَتِهِ فَيَنْسَخُ اللَّهُ مَا يُلْقِي الشَّيْطَانُ ثُمَّ يُحْكِمُ اللَّهُ آيَاتِهِ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what is happening. The incident was from shaitan, and it was a trials over the kuffar. The shaitan tried to deceive the kuffar and creating fitna for the kuffar, that they hear that Muhammad telling them this, but in the fact he didn't tell them anything. And what Prophet Muhammad ﷺ only recited the word of Allah, and the fabrication, the two statement added by shaitan, it was a fitna over the kuffar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained, and they fail the kuffar, and they fall in the fitna and the trap of the shaitan, wal-iyadhu billah. So after that, when they found out the kuffar, they keep torturing and doing all the evil, they decided to migrate again to Abyssinia for the second time. For what? For the second time. And how many people they decided to go? Who knows? Anyone have an idea? First time they were 10, small number, with their wives, and the second time they went 70, more little bit, 83 among of the Sahaba, they went for the second migration to Abyssinia, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped them, and they decided to migrate for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, running with their religion, and they arrive to that a justice ruler, Abyssinia. And after that, when they arrive and they seek protection from that leader and safety, he gave them the safety and he gave them the protection. And there were amazing incident happen, inshallah, for the following class. We will explain what the kuffar did. They sent Amr ibn al-As, that time he wasn't Muslim, and later he became Muslim, radiallahu anh. They sent Amr ibn al-As, and he was the most intelligent man and very smart, and his speaker, he's very strong in politician and speaking and eloquent, and he went with the gold and money to go to Najashi to stimulate his heart and give him the money, and in order that the coast Muslim who believe 83 people to give back to Amr al-As, to send them back to Mecca and torture them and not let them to leave with the freedom. Inshallah, for the following class, we will continue about this. And today, what we learned, that if you're not able to practice your Islam, you practice your religion, you practice your faith, and you fall in big fitna, it's best solution that you migrate, to change your lifestyle, change the environment, change your situation, change your location. This is really important because your deen is more important than anything. More important than money, more important than children, more important than any relative. Your Islam, your Iman is number one, and everything comes second and third and fourth. So in order to protect your deen, because you have one life, and you have to live your life according in believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doing righteous deed. Jazakumullahu khayran wa ahsanallahu ilaykum wa assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have some question here.
Okay.